Hi folks, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande.
Welcome to another new video on Room Database. In the previous video, we have got started with the implementation of repository. In this case, country repository. We have implemented two methods, fetch and insert all, and get all countries. With these two methods, we have the initial setup ready. Let's just wire up the remaining code to load the countries and render them on the screen. If you have a look at where we are in terms of the design flow, this is how it would look like. In the repository, we have basically implemented two functions, that is fetch and insert all and get all entries. This is exactly what you saw a few moments back. The first thing that we want to do is basically wire up the code and see how our country would get rendered using this architecture. So now what we would be doing is implement the components that come even before repository, that is view model and composable. We already have the composable. The only thing that is missing here is view model using the repository and then wiring up the code of the composable with view model. So let's get into a demo. So this is the country repository. We are seeing some error here, main activity. What is the error? So earlier, our get country list was not a suspend function, but now it has become a suspend function that is giving us an error. So what I will do is just remove this. This is not needed here. And then country scaffold, I don't want to pass the countries here. So that once again removes the need for this. And now if I go to scaffold, the main screen, we are passing the country list. We want to initialize that within the main screen because main screen is a composable. So we will remove this as well. So right now this thing is giving a compilation error. Let's comment it out. And we will come back to this later. Now, let me close all of this. This is our repository and it is time to get started with the implementation of ViewModel. So let me create a new Kotlin class, CountryViewModel. This CountryViewModel should take the parameter of repository. So private val CountryRepository and it should extend ViewModel. And then in this, one thing we need to maintain is country list, and then we need variable to check whether it is loading or not loading. So loading status val all countries. This would be of mutable state of list of country. Let me create a mutable state of empty list. So initially this will be empty. We have already covered what is mutable state, how to use a mutable state all in the initial series of the composables, that is as a part of the state management. So I hope you are already aware. And then we will maintain another state val is loading. It will be a mutable state of boolean type, and let me initialize it with default value true. Now we need functions to basically invoke fetch and insert all and get all countries. As soon as this thing loads, we need to basically fetch and insert. So we need a init block. Inside that, we will have to call a fetch and insert all method. Instead of directly calling, let me write another private function here, private suspend function, fetch and insert all. It uses country repository and makes a fetch and insert all. And after this, get all countries. So we will write another function, private suspend function, get all countries. It initializes all countries dot value with repository, that is country repository dot get all countries. And this I can invoke here after inserting all. I want to initialize this all countries after I fetch them and insert them in the database. Because this is a suspend function, I want to ensure that this doesn't get invoked until this insertion happens. So what I will do is I will put it under a view model scope and then launch it and assign a job. Once again, this is all part of the way we work with coroutines. So this returns me the job, and job join get all countries will have to wait. And after that, loading dot value can be made false because now the data has got loaded. So now we have implemented fetch and insert all and also get all countries. Now we will have to invoke this as our country view model gets initialized. So in the init block, I can write view model scope, which is a coroutine scope dot launch fetch and insert all. So as soon as this loads, that is view model loads, it invokes this fetch and view insert all, and then it initializes by invoking get all countries and initializing the all countries and then making is loading equals to false. By default, it is true. So initially when you launch your application, you will see a continuously busy running symbol. So we have the view model. Now let me go to the composable, that is main screen. So here what we will have to do is initialize the data access object and then initialize the repository and then initialize the view model. But to do all of this, the first thing that we would need is a context. So let me get hold of a context, that is val context is equal to local context dot current, and let me initialize the DAO, that is val country DAO is equal to app database. App database is basically the class that we had implemented, which gives me the instance of the app database dot get database, and then here I pass context dot application context I get country DAO. Have the country DAO val country repository is equal to country repository and then pass country DAO, and not only that, you need to pass the context as well. So country DAO could be nullable, so let's wrap it with let, and then finally we need to initialize the model view model country view model. I cannot write country view model and then directly pass the country repository. I mean, it might look like we might be able to do it, but it will definitely fail. The reason why it will fail is view model is basically managed by Android operating system. You cannot create or should not create new instances of view model every time the recomposition happens. So to check whether a view model exists, if it exists, then you're reusing the existing view model and also making sure that it is working in synchronization with the lifecycle of the composable is very, very important. That is why the common mechanism to initialize the view model is using the view model factory. If your view model doesn't have any parameter, then you can just use the default view model. But our view model will be taking a country repository, so it is a custom view model. So we will have to give the implementation of how this view model factory should look like. So to do that, let me create another class which is called as country view model factory. Let me create a package first, call it as view model, and move this here just for better structure. And in the view model, let me create a Kotlin class called as country view model factory. Here I can say private val country repository. This extends view model provider dot factory, and then I will override create. And what I am basically doing is creating an instance of country view model using the factory design pattern. So what I will do is, if this model class is assignable from country view model class Java, then I am writing return country view model repository as I am typecasting it into this T. I think unchecked cast. So what it is saying that it might not be proper casting. So what I will do is I will add a annotation, suppress unchecked cast, and then if this doesn't work out, I will throw illegal argument exception and basically complain that unknown model class. So now we will use this particular model factory to create the view model in composable. So let me go back here, I will use factory country view model factory and then pass the repository, this country repository. So let me write it with let because it could be a nullable. So this is complaining that return an existing view model. Let me give the type of the view model here, that is country view model. So val country list is equal to view model dot all countries dot value, and in the same way val is loading is equal to once again view model dot is loading dot value. So when isLoading is true, I need to basically show a circular progress indicator. This code should take care of that. That is, in a box at the center of the screen, I am showing the circular indicator. Else, that is, if it is not loading, that basically means the data has got loaded. So it's time to render the country card in the lazy column. So items, country list, and inside items, I can say country card, country info, it. That's it. We are basically done with the implementation. So what did we do? We got hold of the context. We created the DAO. We created the repository instance. And then we created the country view model. But to create the country view model, we had to implement the factory pattern using the ViewModelProvider.Factory. And then later in the view model, we have basically written the function to initialize our mutable states of country list and the isLoading. Time to run this code and check. So let me run this particular application. As you can see, it's showing load and then it is loading the country, but there is a problem. I am seeing only one country. There are around 250 countries in my API. So how do I check what is there in the database? Is there a way to inspect it? The answer is yes. Under tool windows app inspection, you should get it, app inspection, select the process. This is the application, that is country info app. You can see that it is already showing the country database, and here it is basically showing the database that has got created. Now let me double click on this. Yes, there is a problem here. I am only seeing one entry here. There is supposed to be more than one. What could be the problem? That is one part. The other part is, where is the implementation of these DAO classes and app database? Well, if you go to the build here, under build, generated, source, capped, here under the dot database, you will see that app database dot implementation and country DAO implementation. And if you see here, this is the generated class for the annotation processor that we added while implementing the country DAO and the app database DAO. So we are almost there. There is a problem, and we have figured out that when I check the database, there is only one entry. It is time to do a little bit of debugging, fix that, and then move on to building the remaining functionality. So here is a challenge. The code is there. Check out the code. Try to figure out why only one database entry is getting added. In the next video, we will fix that and move on to complete the remaining part of the feature. So stay tuned for the next.
That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.